Whoops. Good afternoon, everyone. I just accidentally changed my desktop audio setting, so let me just fix that, because it's probably real loud now. Whoops. 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 Ah. Zhongli, do your thing. Do a talk. Bear with me, everyone. It's been like, what, 2 months since we streamed last? I gotta make sure everything's working. That wiggly is adorable.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember. But where are those who share the memory?
A little more. That's probably okay. If it's a little loud, let me know, since I accidentally touched my slider. And now everything's all not how I had it set anymore. And I don't remember what the setting was, so. Oh! Wait. Actually, hold on. Oh, I got undo button. I'm real smart. I'm real smart. I just did that the hard way, only to realize that I could have been doing it the easy way the entire time. This is standard Mez experience. Anyways, hello everyone. Welcome back. It has been a while. I didn't want to miss Lantern Rite. So, here we are. We're making it work. We're doing the thing. Because I love Lantern Rite. And I want to do that with all of you. So, first, we gotta do housekeeping stuff. We gotta get rid of all these exclamation marks. We're not gonna do that. Because I probably have to scan some QR code or something. Go away, I already looked at you. Why are you still there? I looked at... Go away. Go away. I looked at you. Okay, well, I guess that's just gonna stay there.
The same as I remember.
So we're just gonna have that exclamation mark on our character screen for a little while. Don't worry about it. Still let me know if things are a little loud, because, like, I might have the volume turned up on my computer, too. It's been a while. Did you know there's new furnishings and stuff? I've been making new furnishings. Also, I've been real lax about playing the game during this time. So, like, yeah.
If you ever...
Everyone is pretty far behind. And I am actually... Remember how we used to joke about how I would never run out of those, the magic crystals? Yeah. I have 35 left. Remember when I used to have, like, thousands? That's what happens when you don't play and do any of your dailies or even your weeklies for, like, over a month. It has been that long. I am now actually starting to hurt for materials. Do your dailies. Hello, Raiders! Toot-roo. Welcome! You haven't missed anything yet, we just started. Let me watch your clip. Hold on, I want to see it. I'm hoping this was an epic moment.
Oh my god. No, y'all can't blame this on me.
Uh-oh.
Y'all can't blame this on me.
Maybe not.
You can't blame that on me.
Oh. Well then. Hello, Ultra Silence. Welcome. I hope you were having a good time in your stream today.
Next?
Don't mind Zhongli.
If you'd like to see Liyue's
chorus
spots.
He's got a lot to say.
I have a few references.
He's actually really good at, like, telling stories and stuff. So he's a really good guide, actually. If you want to follow him, get the tour around Liyue. He's, like, the best person for it. I can't tell you his secrets. In case you haven't played and you don't want spoilers, or, you know, maybe there's people in your chat. chat who don't want to. We're gonna do Lantern Rite today! It's this really cool festival that comes around once a year in Genshin Impact. Yes, it's just like the real life Lantern Rite festival. We make lanterns, and we do the wishes, and we share good memories and foods and stuff. And it's really wholesome and beautiful, actually. Like, beautiful. Highly recommend. Stream was fun. Good! 4 hours is a long stream. It is. I appreciate that. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Marshmallow Grove. I hope you enjoy your stay here. We're pretty comfy. We like to chill together and have a good time. We play a lot of Genshin Impact here. But we also play other things. If I am horrible at using my party right now, don't worry about that. It's completely mismatched with a bunch of random characters because I need companionship XP on them. So we make it work. It'll be fine. Trust me. Just listen.
Stabilize.
It'll be fine. I am also struggling with relearning my camera controls, so like, don't worry about it. If it seems like I'm having a hard time sometimes, I probably am.
Can't see.
It'll be fine. Easy. I actually really like getting that commission. It's really easy. Well, yeah, you're here for just in time for housekeeping. We haven't started anything too important yet, because we usually do our housekeeping first, so that everyone has a little bit of time to get here. Have a good lurk, Ultra Silence. Get some good sleep. It is good to get rest. It is important. Zhongli is so tall, but not tall enough to reach that geocrystal fly. It's always out of reach. Just out of reach. We could probably put a pillar down and climb up and catch it, but like, I'm not real good at my controls right now. So, we just won't worry about it. Watch this. Watch this. If the Abyss Mage follows me, it'll die. And I don't have to do anything. Hold on. Let's see. I did! It followed us! Look at it! Unfortunately, it didn't follow us all the way out over the water. But wait. Wait. Wait for it. Hold on. We'll wait for it to do a teleport thing. Gonna teleport out over the water. Wait for it. Ah. Well, never mind. This one's too smart for us. We were so close. So close to greatness. Oh wait, these ones don't have to think. They're all dead.
Solidify.
I see everything.
By the way, I really like Naga. She is actually it's kind of funny. Yes, pull me closer where I can get you faster. How very wise of you. Easy. You know what's nice about her move is it links these enemies together, so when I hit this one, it also damages that one. Not like literally. I don't do the same damage to them by hitting one of them, but it causes a reaction that also does damage to the other one. Who is still attacking? Is it the Abyss Mage? Is it the Abyss Mage? It's the Abyss Mage. Look at him. Look at them over there. They're doing their best. All right, then. Hold on. I have a plan. I can aim. Okay, listen. I got this. There we go. Easy. Now I need the items, though. All right. Next time we'll get the Abyss Mate to come out over the water so that it breaks its own shield. and then falls in the water and dies. Next time. I'll show you. Just, we'll get it sometime. Eventually. Possibly. I still have achievements to accomplish in Liyue that involve the random dailies that I get there, so we're gonna be here. We'll get it. And then you'll see. Then you'll all see. I miss Zhao. Not that I don't like Zhongli. Like, Zhongli will always be Geodad, okay? We love our Geodaddy. But I miss Zhao. He doesn't take damage when I do this. Zhongli will always be in our party anyway, though. We like his shields. They're useful. They make Ningguang do more damage.
I see everything!
When we're using her. Which we're not right now. But everyone appreciates a good shield, right? So... Who's still alive? Come here.
What it is?
Get down. Easy. Okay, but these guys... We can't do anything to them now. This is fine. Ow! Mistakes were made! Ah. It's fine. Kainari's tough, he'll be okay. I can't see. Please. Sometimes, the camera betrays you. It's okay, that's why we have Zhongli. So that when the camera betrays us, we're still okay. Wait, that wasn't the last one? We got one more. One more. People are running out of time to get here. Okay, they got bonus time. They got bonus time. If you've been here for our dailies before, you know where we are. We have to check for the pink angels here. You know when we get these commissions, and they come up to this area, we have to take the extra few seconds to check the pink angels. You know we do. We need daytime. Hold on. Wait. Hold. Hold, chat.
Every journey has its final day.
All right.
Don't rush.
Nothing decorative. That's too bad. We tried. This is why we always check, though, because you see that pink angel there? If that one's decorative, you can only get that angel at this mission spot. So. We gotta check if we're in the area. We need some of those. Huh? I want them. Oh, great! We got this commission. What's so bad about this commission, you ask? We get to climb a mountain. So this guy and this chick, they kind of like, they're on an adventure together or something. I don't remember exactly. And she's got a cough. And he wants to make her tea to make her feel better. But she's the type that doesn't want to be taken care of and refuses to admit when, you know, she's having a problem. So he has to do it secretly. So he wants us to go and climb this cliff over here and get him some flowers because otherwise she'll notice. And he tells her that they're for him, but then he makes her drink them too. He says he has a migraine or something, I think. I don't remember. I've done this commission so many times. I may have made a mistake. We might need to, like, find somewhere to let Zhongli stand. Like, right here? Can you... No. Oh, gosh! Okay. It's fine. We're fine. We're fine. We can probably stand over here. And we can get this violet grass on the way, too. Remember when you had to go around for hours collecting this violet grass? Because it's on all these cliffs. And it's just terrible to collect. Remember that? Death to true. Hello. How are you? Missed all of you too. Hugs. Yes. Hugs are the best. We're here. It's time. We're doing our housekeeping. We're doing dailies. And then we're gonna pull for Alhaitham. Everyone got a little extra time to get here because we got this commission that makes us climb up this mountain to get these specific flowers. You know, even though we have a ton of them in our inventory, no, they need the fresh ones. They can't just use the ones that we already have. They have to make us climb and get the fresh ones. Stop air blowing me up when I'm not trying to go up. You're doing good. Good. I'm also doing good. Having fun. Doing my dailies. Doing a chill. You can tell her what he was actually doing instead of playing along with him. You can tell her. I don't think it gives you an achievement or anything. But you can. You don't have to pretend and go along with his story.
Ad Astra. Thank you for
free companionship XP. Yes. Easy. All right. Also, we need to do these. Who wants to go fight the dude? Remember this guy? It's okay if you don't yet. We're not actually inside the domain yet. We need this party. I still die on his big move every time right now because, like, I haven't quite figured out how to make him not do it. Not that I've tried that hard because, like, I have so many revival foods. So it just kind of doesn't really bother me. But, maybe you'll be here for the first time that I figure it out. Maybe this is the time.
Before me, worm!
I know that I have to shoot the thing at something, but I don't know what I'm supposed to shoot it at.
Stabilize!
Sure.
This is order!
Hold the line! Right here, emerge!
Oh no.
Feeble human!
Excuse me. Yeah. Let me do the thing. Let me do the thing. Why aren't you letting me do the thing?
Gather.
Why aren't you letting me
think?
Look at. My energy is fully charged, and they're not letting me do the thing. I also don't really understand how to get out of this.
Solidify.
Like, they can't actually expect us to jump over every single one of those, can they? Maybe they can. Okay. It's fine.
Sure! Gather!
It's no.
Let me use the thing. Let me use the thing.
Insignificant pest!
Submit!
Whoops, I didn't use my things. I don't even know what that does in this first round. Like, I actually don't.
Right now.
Ow. No. I don't really know how to do this fight. Skip. There we go. I just kind of go through.
A thousand eons, mine to dominate.
Right here. Emerge.
Burn to oblivion!
No, I refuse.
Kneel!
No, you. Ready to go. Okay, he's doing the thing. We're not gonna use it yet. We gotta wait for him to sit still. Oh, jeez. I was not expecting the stomps. We're fine. Wait, it didn't do the thing? But I told you to do the thing. I very clearly told you to do the thing. Now I have no shield.
Reality is pain.
Gather.
Platform and see the thing. Now I finally know what it does. This could be useful. It could be. We'll keep it. Alright, next. The ones we're more used to. We have to get our weekly items, because now it's even more important. Because I'll hate them. And I don't know which one he uses, so I've been trying to at least get in here and...
Evil shall be dispersed.
Do what my orders to make sure I have the things I need. Just in case, because I don't know which one he gets. We have to find the boss for him, too, because we're going to need the boss materials. We have a lot of stuff we need to do.
Born of ice and frost. Right here, right now. Inferior. Nothing lasts forever.
Evil conquering!
Be gone! The eye sweeps the lands.
Oh, that's going to be fine. We'll be fine.
Worthless!
Worthless!
Stabilize!
Access denied. Emerge. Right now. Right here.
Weak. Pathetic.
Says you. Ow.
Inferior. Lightning falls on the land of eternity.
Oh, jeez. I hate the invisible barrier.
This body is eternal.
Order guide you. Gather.
Come on up.
That was not the right character.
Born of ice and frost. Perish.
No.
This is order.
Show them.
I keep switching to the wrong one. I used to having gotten you in the top slot.
Solidify.
Born of ice and frost. Eternity is in my hands.
Gather. Order guide you.
No touching. For Rex Lapis. Come on out. Right now, right here. A sight to behold. Right now, right here, right now.
Lament!
Only easy. Emptiness awaits.
Baby. We got two play items. Yes. Excellent. Wait. Stop here, get the heal. Because we're smart. Change our party.
Understood.
All is accounted for. Let's move out.
And for this group, we don't need Kagome. We could bring
some in the field research.
We can bring our boy. All right. Let's see if we can get her before her fiery cyclone.
You're trembling. Is it the cold or just cowardice?
Sometimes we can, sometimes we can't. Sometimes she, like, teleports all over the
Stabilize.
Place.
I will have
impossible.
Order.
I put that a little farther away than I was planning. Fine. Yeah.
Submit!
Not what I was trying to attack.
Solidify!
Okay, we look for the butterflies. There's one.
Stabilize!
It's fine, we're not actually frozen. We got really good placement on those butterflies. Nice. All right, here we go. Moment of truth.
Solidify.
Live. Feel this ancient power.
Right here. Emerge. Right now.
Give up.
Stop. teleporting around. Yeah!
Don't waste my time.
This is order.
But I never asked for redemption. Never.
Win. So what's that achievement we just got? What was that? Defeat Signora without destroying either her Hearts of Flame or Eyes of Frost. So we didn't destroy any? Usually Zhongli accidentally destroys at least one. Very nice. Achievement get. Now we fight the angry boy. If you didn't know, we have a plushie of our angry boy now. He's great. He's up on my shelf on top of all of my games. Raiko is here. She says hello. We should have healed. Ah, Albedo's are fine. He's full. Wrong menu.
We'll need a strategy.
Yes, nerd.
Allow me!
We could bring Xiao, or we could bring, like, Hu Tao, or Yanfei. We'll bring Xiao. I like bringing Xiao. Conquering demons is what Xiao does. We're gonna take him to conquer the angriest boy. Let's go. We fight the boy.
It is time, Morax. We settle this now.
Right here. Right now.
Boring.
Needs more energy.
The enraged Earth
solidify
will not absolve you.
Allow me.
Today, you witness your reckoning.
No, you. He seems to forget every week.
Right here, right
that
now.
That he is the one who, in fact, witnesses his reckoning.
I'm always watching. Right now, emerge. Right here.
There is no atonement for causing your pain.
Now, wait, switch. Oh, jeez.
Stabilize.
You stand upon your tomb, though you know it not. Come. Experience an eon of suffering.
No. I'm good. Oh, jeez. Close. Very close.
Gather!
Allow me!
Emerge! Right now! Emerge!
Disappear! Here! Useless!
Worthless!
Here!
We'll be fine. Here. We'll be fine. We're not fine.
Solidify! Order guide you!
Hold the line!
Boring!
Easy. All right. Okay. It's time to do the thing. It is time for thing dues. We have to go to our spot to do our pulse. Because it is time. What's this? Oh, we have to do the thing to get this too. Okay, let's go to our place. Let's go to our spot. We'll go sit at our table so we can do our pulls. Look at him. Look at how cute and small he is. I love him. Love him. He's my boy and I
understood.
Love him. Wrong party. Here we go. Back at our... No! Stop! Diluc! Back at our party. So we can... Go do pulls. I love Leeway music. Alright. We should sit in this chair. Let me sit. Why can't I sit in this one? There we go. Okay, I'm gonna sit in this one, because those two spots are taken by Zhongli and Venti, I think, if I remember correctly. Alright. We can do the things now. First, we have to do the test run. Because free Primo Gems. And also, we gotta try them out. So this is the new material we need to get. I don't even know if we can get to that boss yet. Because we still haven't explored the desert or anything, because we're still not done with a bunch of side quests we need to do. Alright, so let's learn how Alhaitham works. Generates mirrors. Changes his damage to Dendro. Attacks activate projection attacks. Determined by the number of mirrors present. His burst deals Dendro damage to opponents. If light mirrors are present, they will increase the damage. After the ability is done, new mirrors will be created based on the number of mirrors consumed. Okay. So let's actually look at his abilities now. Let's see. So we can hold to choose where we go, or we can just use the skill to rush forward. Do they do different damage? No. There's no reason to hold it then, unless we're trying to get somewhere specific. Okay. If there's no mirrors at the time, he'll generate an additional mirror. So we'll get two mirrors on the first move. Okay. We can have three mirrors. Okay. We're learning. What is this? If we hit them with a charge or a plunging attack, we generate a mirror. Okay. That's good to know. We could get our three mirrors immediately then. His elemental mastery increases the projection attacks. And his burst. Okay. Okay, alright. We have the information. We have no shields. We only have heals. So, let's do this. Oh. That's not what I'm
saying. Let's dance!
This is fine. Okay, now we do a charge attack. Now we have all of our mirrors, and we can do the thing.
Elimination.
Okay, noted. That spawns in front of us. Where's my mirrors? I don't see them. I thought it was supposed to regenerate them. Okay, so my mirrors go away real fast.
By royal decree!
I thought it was supposed to give me two mirrors when I did that. Exit. Okay. We're learning. We're learning. It seems like his mirrors go away real fast. Now we know. Okay, and we need to go do Zhao, because free Primo gems. Well, we already know how to use our boy, so this will be easy.
Let the show begin.
It's okay. We just have to hit them a lot.
Here we go. Conquering. Worthless.
Now everything dies.
Tear. Disappear.
We'll be fine. We don't need these. This is the last one. Mine's better. Easy. Free Primos. Primo gems. Give. This is the other new character. I don't know if we'll get her or not. We'll see. Because, you know, we're not going to go out of our way to get her. Let's go ahead and try her. Because she's new, and I actually don't know anything about her. Okay. So, we summon a thing. Throws white jade radishes that will heal characters and deal dendro damage. Okay. So she's a healer? Kind of? Elemental burst puts her in a mode. Okay. Movement speed and dendro resistance. Continuously summon white jade radish things until their maximum numbers are reached. Okay, what's the maximum number? Heal all nearby characters. Okay, so she's a healer.
Why do so many people make such a big deal out of seeking the Adepti? There's Adepti everywhere, isn't there?
She has bells. I like bells. They jingle! Yes. Okay. Let's actually look at her talents and understand what the heck is going on. Okay. You can aim them. Whoops. Heals based on HP. So they only explode if they hit an opponent or a character. This doesn't sound like a healing that I would enjoy. Let's just get through this trial. I am, not impressed at
all. You're in for a little shock. Come a little closer. You're in for a little shock.
You're up!
Cute.
Ready, go!
So the maximum number is 4? Oh, that didn't last long at all.
Surrender and be gentle.
What are you attacking? The enemy's over here.
Come a little closer. Yep.
She's cute, but I don't think I like her. There we go. All right, we're ready. It's time. It's time to do the pulls. We have 25 wishes right now. Let's go in and get 5 more. I seriously doubt we're getting him in 5 wishes, but we can hope. We can hope. Let's try. Let's go. First pull. Nothing. Next. Second pull. Nothing. Jesus! We're getting a lot of Yunjins. Three. Why? Nothing. New bow? I'm not sure if I already have one of those or not. But neat! New bow! Or another bow. Okay. We need more. Let's get like 50. Easy. Hopefully we can win the 50-50 and save some wishes, since I have been very lazy. We complained about Yunjin and got Shangling. You could at least give me the character that I don't have. They said no. Sacrificial sword. Nothing. There we go! Ask and you shall receive. We got the new character. I don't want a 5-star weapon, I'm on the character banner. No. Zodiac's trying to ruin our 50-50. There we go, 50-50! Let's go! Not yet. Wait. Hold. Hold. Do we win the 50-50? Do we save some wishes? Please. Yes! The boy comes home! We got him! Oh, I'm excited. Yes! We won the 50-50. Congratulations, Marshmallows. We have not been punished for being lazy. Alright. Okay, alright. We do the new character things. Let's go. I'm gonna have to collect some stuff for them. But first, let's get in here and get rid of these exclamation points. There we go. Do the character selection. There. Now his I'll probably actually read at some point. Not all of these, because these are just voice lines, right? Never mind. These are more than voice lines. We'll have to check them out sometime. These ones are voice lines. We will check out Alhaitham lore at some point. I don't think we have any of the things needed to level him. So we probably won't be getting too much for him. But we'll use him soon. Yes, I know I just wasted 825 XP. I don't care. Wait, we actually have those?
Wait.
When did I get these?
Whatever.
Found in tunnels? When did I get these? I have exactly three. When did I get these? Okay, well, I guess
we get
to level him up. You're welcome. But he's so polite. Aww. Excitement. I'll have to go hunting for those. But not today. Today we're doing Lantern Rite. I'll probably hunt for them on my own. I'll figure out where they are and I'll get them and...
Wait. Huh? No.
What?
Whatever.
Whatever? What? Got some kind of cool key. He doesn't want to tell us about it. I don't even know if I have any, like, artifacts for him. Why do you still have an exclamation mark? What? This? Why do you still have Oh! That's right, I forgot we have a story tab. Another thing we'll have to check out at some point. I don't have the Dendro Glider yet, so I don't know what we're gonna give him. Maybe this one, actually. Doesn't look too bad. No. Hold on, we'll wait and get a look at this one. Because this is my favorite glider. Well, second favorite. Maybe favorite. My favorites might be tied. Probably this one, I think. It kind of matches. Wait. Select? Okay, it's already on it. Good. Let's see. What weapons do we have that we could give you? What do you need? You need elemental mastery. And then other standard DPS stats. So... we could give him this, since it's leveled. It would be better than nothing. We'll probably just give him that for now. And I'll look into what else we can give him. And I'm guessing we're going to want the Dendro set. We might end up giving him Nida's set after we're done with her. Either that or Tainari's, because I don't know how much we'll use Tainari since we'll have him and Nahida. So... yeah, it looks like we're not really... we're probably not set up for him right now. Yeah. We'll figure it out eventually. We can't use him right now. I can't level him enough. What? Why are you still why do you still have an exclamation point in the character selection? Why? What do you want from me? All of them. There. I don't know why. Oh, here. Oh, right, we got constellations for characters we don't care about. I forgot about that. So, we decrease a cooldown. We increase normal attack damage. We leveled up something. We increase defense. Wow, we've actually never gotten a constellation for... really? Alright. Okay. Now we're good. Now we got them all. This is probably gonna be spending money? No, 50 wishes. Always a nice XP boost. Okay. Alright. We're ready to do Lantern Rite. Let's get on a party of people we like. Not that we don't like these people.
Understood.
There. Okay. Lantern Rite. Let's do it. Let's do the things. You already missed the opening where I ran into Zhongli in Liyue, and he was like, hey, go get some things for me.
Bamboo shoot. Nascent bamboo shoot. Oh! This one's only just sprouted! And it looks super fresh! Paimon thinks this is the one!
Okay, Paimon. I'm gonna collect the bamboo shoots too, though. Isn't there more up here? Excuse me, I'm just looking for bamboo shoots. Because I thought there was more. There they are. We need these for certain recipes, and I don't come out here often enough. So when I'm out here, I try to go around and pick them up. Because they're only out here. Plus, I like the music, so, like, chill. Excuse me, you're ruining my music. I've been through here a few times to get them now, so I remember where most of them are. I don't remember if there was one up here. No, it's just the pot to collect random stuff from. And there's like a couple more up here in the village. Village is this way. There's like pine cones on the bridge and stuff. We can grab those too. I use them to make puppy paw hash browns. It's a special recipe that Razor can make if you didn't know. The healing food. This is also a great place to collect glaze lilies if you need them. And Joyune chilies. The glaze lilies are all in these gardens. The Joyune chilies are like along the path and on the little cliffs on the side here. Right over there, there's some. I don't really use them for anything in particular, but they make good extras for like various recipes when I'm actually needing to refill on healing items. So I'll grab them if they're not like super out of the way. These are probably decorations for Lantern, right? I'm sure they'll have something to do with some quest or something. We'll get to find out what they are. The other bamboo shoots are up here. All of them? Yeah. Alright, we keep doing the quest.
This should be enough. Let's head back.
Help! Help!
Uh-oh.
Did you hear that? Someone's calling for help!
Hi!
It's coming from over there!
Yao Yao's here.
Are you okay? Did any water go down the wrong pipe?
Oh, he's dressed fancy.
I think I'm okay now. Thank you so much.
I like your hat.
That was scary. Well, at least you're all right. All thanks to your savior here. Oh, a little girl?
That's Yao Yao.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Yao Yao. It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Whoa, she's so well-mannered. My name's Paimon, and this is the Traveler.
I have a name.
I'm Dvorak, a musician from Fontaine. I came through Stone Gate, intending to head towards Liyue Harbor, but then I became captivated by the beautiful scenery. And before long, I was completely lost.
Aw.
Just
okay,
now, I was
too.
So mesmerized by the waterfall that I slipped and fell into the water.
Oh.
If it weren't for Miss Yao Yao's help, I shudder to think what might have happened.
You should be more careful.
It's all right, Mr. Dvorak. The splashing around the bottom of the waterfall means the stone path is always wet and slippy. You definitely have to be careful. Next time you're exploring an unfamiliar environment, try to focus on what's right in front of you. Don't let your mind wander. As long as you watch your step, accidents like this won't happen anymore.
That's not true.
Yes, ma'am. I understand. I'll remember to be more careful next time.
Good job. Aw, you hungry. You want a radish?
Oh, are you hungry, sir?
I'll be fine.
Please, sir, it's quite all right. I was born and raised here in Liyue. It's only natural for me to extend my hospitality to any guests who are passing through. I expect you still have quite a long journey ahead of you. It's very important to keep your energy levels up. I still have some lotus flower crisps left in my backpack. Why don't we split them between the four of us?
I have my own.
Aww, what a thoughtful kid! She even has some for Paimon!
You're welcome.
Mmm, so tasty. If only there were more.
And Paimon already ate a ton.
Having a healthy appetite is a good thing. It means Paimon's still growing.
No, it doesn't.
If I'd known I was going to run into you, I would have made a second batch.
Hope you're taking notes, Traveler. This is how you treat your Paimon.
No.
What do you think, sir? Are Liyue snacks to your taste? I wonder if they're not sweet enough.
No, they're perfect. When I was traveling through Mondstadt, I had a chance to try one of their moon pies. It had a meat filling, unlike these crisps. But apart from that, it seems like they follow a similar cooking process. Both are delicious in their own way. As for Fontaine's cooking, though, it's been a long time since I've had a taste of home.
Aw.
Sounds like you spend a lot of time on the road, huh?
I do. It's part of my job. I'm one of the main organizers of the Iridescence Tour.
Iridescence Tour?
I don't know what that is. Is that like the event that's going on? Tell us about it.
The Iridescence Tour is one of the biggest music festivals in Fontaine.
Oh.
We're looking to expand, though. Our aim is to hold a festival in every nation.
No, thank you.
At least, thank you. All the main organizers share this goal. Unfortunately, it's a long story, so I'll spare you the details. But anyway, so the main reason I'm traveling all around Tevat is to promote our music festivals. But I have some personal reasons, too.
Well, what are they? Just tell us already!
Let me see. Well, to explain it in full, I'd have to start with a story from my ancestors.
Story time!
I don't want to take up too much of your time.
Please, take up my time.
I love listening to stories.
Yes! Finally, someone who gets it.
Yeah,
you too! No, Paimon,
okay.
In the past,
then I'll start from
you
the
have
beginning.
Been completely opposed
the
to
story
this.
The story goes that my ancestor, who was also a traveler, once slipped and fell into a lake during his travels. As he was sinking and gasping for breath, he heard a wondrous tune in the air. They say it was the most beautiful, moving melody he had ever heard. Even in that life and death moment, the ethereal music seized his full attention and almost made him forget the fact that he was drowning. When he finally came to, he found that he had already been brought ashore. Not too far from him stood an unfamiliar woman with an almost divine aura. Once she saw that he was no longer in danger, she left without a word. My ancestor tried to run after her to give his thanks, but although a mere dozen paces separated them, no matter how quickly he gave chase, he drew no closer and remained a dozen paces behind. In the end, all he could do was to bow in thanks to the woman as he watched her walk away towards the rivers and mountains in the distance, before at last he turned around and made his way home. Once he returned to Fontaine, he began to learn an instrument so that he could spread his story far and wide. Just like the bards. After generations of retelling, embellishing, and dramatizing, people have come to think of that lady as something like a fairy.
Hmm.
The story's become something of a local legend in Fontaine. It's called The Lady Overlooking the Lake. People now say that if you go down to the lakeside and play an instrument, so long as you play a pleasing melody, you will hear a fairy lady who is hiding out of sight playing along with you.
Wow!
That's neat. And its heart is a true story? What story?
Exactly. It may just be a legend to others, but for me, it's a real part of my family history. I wanted to find out the truth of this tale. So I decided to retrace my ancestors' steps and search for that lady's modern-day descendants. Of course, there's no way of knowing where my ancestor fell into the lake all those years ago. So I always knew that the search would be akin to looking for a needle in a haystack. I've spent many years on the road now, and I'm nowhere near as fit as I was in my youth. The wish that I've spent half my life chasing after has now become something of an obsession.
I haven't lived half of my life yet, but still, I understand how you must feel.
I mean, too! It's like... imagine if you stayed the center of a lotus flower crisp, which is the best part, by the way, because you wanted to eat it another day. But then suddenly, sploosh! It falls into the water, never to be seen again! Paimon would definitely remember that for the rest of her life.
Really?
There's no need to feel sorry for me. I've made some progress over the years. For example, I've concluded that the story must have taken place in Liyue.
Oh, so you finally found a lead?
Yes, in fact, that's an intriguing story in and of itself.
More story time?
I'd always known that Mondstadt is the city of song and freedom. But more recently, I heard that the animal Archon returned to Mondstadt for a festival in the fall, and learned that he himself is a patron deity of music. So I prayed for the Animal Archon's guidance in the Mondstadt Cathedral.
Oh no.
And as soon as I set foot back outside the front gate, I noticed a cluster of leaves being blown in the wind further and further west towards Stone Gate. A friendly local told me that this meant the wind was guiding me in the direction of Liyue. So I followed their advice and made my way here.
Aha. Uh-huh. We should ask Venti if he actually did this.
Right? You get it. I knew I'd find someone that agrees with me eventually.
Are you sure? It sounds a bit too much like one of those fake legends told by those treasure hoarder guys to scam gullible grannies from Qingxia Village. Rex Lapis has returned to the world! Just give me some incense and a little mora towards the travel fees, and I will pass your gift on to the Lord of Geo, and ask him to keep you and your family safe and well, and so on and so on.
Yep.
Don't worry, Yao Yao. We have a lot of experience with deciphering omens and stuff.
Do we?
And anyway, you only got scammed if you handed over mora, right?
No. No.
Actually, to express my gratitude, I did spend rather a lot of mora on several bottles of fine wine, which I left at the Statues of the Seven along the way.
Oh dear.
I'm sure Venti appreciated that.
Well, how about this, ladies and gentlemen? Why don't I bring you all to Yujing Terrace to see Miss Ganyu? I don't know very many people, so I can't help you out much. But Miss Ganyu and the Qixing know just about everything. If you've been scammed, they'll help you get your mora back.
Oh no.
And if the wind was telling the truth, and you want to keep looking for that lady's family, they'll be the best people to ask.
That sounds like a good idea. Oh no. We're gonna get Venti in trouble.
But you've already helped me so much.
Well, I was going to take some new medicinal herbs and plants I picked to Miss Ganyu anyway, so it's no trouble at all.
You know what? It's been a minute since we saw Ganyu too. It should be nice to pay her a visit before Lantern, right?
I am always happy to go and see Ganyu. Let's go.
All right. Well, my sincere thanks to you all. I will never forget your kindness.
Okay, everyone. Please follow me. I'll be your guide. Remember to watch where you're going, okay?
Okay.
Uh-oh. Paimon's out of a job! Oh well, Paimon will just be a cheerleader instead.
That's basically what you already are. And you're bad at it. You're bad at it. You have no faith in me. Well, he's getting scared and stuff. It's like, I'm right here. Ye of little faith, Paimon. Where's Zhao? We should have Zhao in our party. Why don't we have Zhao in our party? It's Lantern, right? We should have Zhao in our party. Where's my boy?
You called?
I did call Zhao. I did. It's Lantern, right? And you're coming with me. I will make you. No, I wouldn't make Zhao come, but I will convince him to come. It's not the same thing. The dog! Doggo, come here! We will feed the dog. I wish we could pet the dog.
Please declare your commercial goods.
I don't have any commercial goods. Please go away. I'm just trying to feed the dog. Look at them. Look at how happy they are. Are you gonna roll over too? No rolling over this time. Okay. Good dog.
Wow. Liyue Harbor looks very different from when I came last.
Because Lantern, right?
It's almost as if I'm listening to the same melody, but with a richer timbre and new variations added.
Well, we are here during Lantern Rite, after all. It only comes once a year, so they always have a big celebration.
I wonder what Lantern's going to be the main Zhao Lantern.
This time of year is when Liyue Harbor looks the prettiest.
Great. Let's go and check it out. I can't wait to get into the city and see it all up close for myself.
Look how pretty it is.
The streets are breathtaking. Smiles and laughter everywhere I look. It's contagious.
Come on.
I can almost feel the music in the air.
You can walk and talk.
I have the urge to start waving my conductor's baton.
You can walk and talk.
I'm glad that you're enjoying the city.
You can walk and talk. Come on. Are you coming? Come on. Come on. A little faster. A little faster. Pick up your feet. Come on. No.
Hi, everyone. A fancy...
Hello, Shenyan. Let me introduce some new friends. They are...
Traveler Paimon and Mr. Dvorak, right?
When I was last here to advertise a Liyue stop for the Iridescence Tour, Shenyan was one of the few people willing to give me the time of day.
It feels like I've been chasing this
I'm so sorry, Shenyan. We've had a string of terrible luck recently, and every time we've tried to put on a show, something or other has come up to stop our plans from materializing.
Aw, is that right? So, what brings you to
a Lantern Rite Music Festival? Yes, please!
Oh, God.
No, I'm actually here on personal business this time.
It's not that I'm opposed to a music festival, it's that I'm opposed to being constantly subjugated to Xinyan's fake accent.
Oh, so...
I mean, that's not just up to me. Hosting a music festival takes a lot of funding and personnel. Moreover, I've never worked with the Liyue authorities before. Even if I were to start putting something together right now, I think it'd be too rushed.
You can plan for
Wait,
next year.
But we're going to meet the Liyue Qixing, aren't we? And they're the ones in charge. Uh-huh, that's right. Miss Kuching and Miss Ningguang can make anything happen.
You mean... what?
This is the perfect opportunity! Well, sure, it might not work out, but it can't hurt to bring it up as a That's the spare! As for the performers, my friend Yunjin...
But what about you, Shenyan? Are you just going to sit this one out?
Please do.
If we actually man...
Wow! There's that rock and roll spirit!
What do you say, Mr.
Okay. I'll give it a shot. But... the opening act is not something to be chosen lightly, Shenyan. I will judge your work by the strictest of standards, so please make sure you are fully prepared.
Are you kidding? Who gets my shopping? Yow yow, if you're-
Okay, I promise I will. Good luck with your music, Shenyan. You've got this, Shenyan!
Fun!
So a senior of yours, Shenyan mentioned just now. Is that anyone we know?
Yes, it's Xiangling. She's mentioned you two before. Xiangling's always thinking about cooking. Whenever she gets scrapes or burns, she just leaves them to heal by themselves. She definitely needs someone around her to look after her. I know you must have looked out for her a lot too in the time you've known her. So, thank you for that.
Keep hearing this noise. Sounded like bad mic noises. I always swim through here to get the fish and the lotus blossoms because they're free and easy. We're gonna see Madam Ping.
Oh, it's Master. Is it okay if I go and say hi to her?
It is always okay to go and say hi to Madam Ping.
Oh, calm down now, dear. I'm not about to run off anywhere. I'm not a bundle of energy like you.
Uh-huh. Sure, Madam Ping.
I haven't seen you in days, Master. I've missed you.
Oh, bless you, Yao Yao. You do say the sweetest things. Ah, look who it is. Visiting friends during the lantern rite, are we?
Yes. We have to track down Zhao and convince him to go to the festival with us. Again.
You're half right, Madam Ping. We were also trying to help out Mr. Dvorak over here. We were on our way to take him to see the Qixing.
But that's not what really matters. This is just a side quest. What really matters is finding Zhao and getting him to come to the festival with us, because we love him.
Hello, ma'am. I am a musician from Fontaine and an organizer of the Iridescence Tour. I don't suppose you've heard of it.
Master! Master! The Iridescence Tour is a super famous music festival!
Super famous.
An old lady like me wouldn't know much about that sort of thing. A music festival, you say? It sounds terribly exciting.
Oh, right! Madam Ping, how would you feel about that?
Adding music to the lantern.
You're an elder of Liyue, and you know all about Liyue's cultural traditions. Hearing your thoughts would definitely help us figure out how best to approach it. For example, do you think it might be a bit too modern, or is there any other issue?
Why, not at all. Music pays homage to history and culture, and it can also be a bridge between different civilizations. Times change, and the music enjoyed by the youngsters of today is no doubt very different from the tunes I was accustomed to in my youth. Nevertheless, all fine things in life can be appreciated. And so, I look forward to it immensely.
Hear, hear! I do believe that, my own dear grandmother aside, you are the wisest old lady I've ever met.
Awesome.
Goodness gracious. You're all being suspiciously sweet today. Yao Yao, whatever have you been feeding them?
Lotus crisps.
Master, you're in such a great mood today. You're even cracking jokes with the rest of us.
Oh, well... I'm sure you must have plenty to be getting on with. Yes? Run along now. Don't let me hold you up.
Thanks, Madam Ping! We'll see you again soon!
Fun. Wholesome. Cute. Oh, are we gonna take the secret elevator? It would be faster to go around the other way if I'm taking the secret elevator. Oh, nope, we're not. Oh, look, it's those people that take advantage of Ganyu.
And when you meet with the Ministry of Civil Affairs, please remind them that the festivities are not an excuse to procrastinate their work.
Yeah, you.
Understood, Miss Ganyu. I'll take my leave now.
Ganyu!
What brings you here, Yao Yao?
I've brought all the medicine you asked me to pick for you. Oh, and here's a pack of sweet flower seeds as well. Also, these dried Qingshan leaves make a great pot of tea that's very good for you.
Yeah,
I know
sweet.
You've had a lot to deal with at work recently, but you shouldn't push yourself too hard. If you're not careful, you'll end up falling asleep in the grass again.
Uh-huh.
Well, this is weird. It's like a responsible younger sister talking to their disorganized older sister.
Ganyu's not disorganized. She just falls asleep sometimes. Don't listen to Paimon.
Thank you, but Paimon's criticism is quite valid. I do have a tendency to neglect matters outside of work, and that's something I should improve on. Oh, my apologies. I don't believe we've been introduced.
Paimon will do the honors.
Music festival stuff.
What's wrong? Did Paimon go over everything a bit too fast?
No, she's thinking.
It's definitely an ambitious plan. If there's anything you didn't quite catch, Paimon's more than happy to go over it again.
It may be a little difficult to make this happen.
Oh?
Well, the Lantern Rite is the most important festival of the year. Our celebrations must not only be visually spectacular, but also appeal to the tastes of Liyue citizens from all walks of life. The Iridescence Tour is relatively unknown in Liyue. It's difficult to predict how a brand new show will be received. It would be quite risky for us to bet everything on this one music festival.
All very valid points. I completely understand.
Therefore, we will not replace or cancel any of our pre-existing program. However, I will submit a proposal requesting to put the Iridescence Tour special performance as the final act of this year's festivities. Some live music will certainly add to the festive atmosphere on the night of the Lantern Rite. As for the venue... Let's reserve a space at the docks.
I think this is a good compromise.
Yes, my thoughts precisely. Now I just need to take some time to give this proposal some polish. As long as I clearly lay out the pros and cons, and highlight the key points of the proposal, given that Ping and the Traveler have both given the idea their blessing, I'm confident that Qixing will be sure to give it serious consideration. Mr. Dvorak, I will need to discuss with you the number of musicians who will be coming to Liyue, as well as their catering and accommodation requirements.
Oh, yes, certainly. Let's step to the side and discuss further.
I like Ganyu.
As soon as there's work to do, Ganyu's as diligent as ever.
I couldn't agree more. Master once said that everyone has things that they are good at and things that they are less good at. So, with that in mind, Ganyu shouldn't feel compelled to become perfect at absolutely everything. I'm good at taking care of people, so that can be left to me.
Wow. Hey, Yao Yao, can you take care of Paimon too?
Please do.
Paimon's getting hungry again.
Please, take Paimon and never give her back. You can have her.
I'm afraid my backpack's empty now, but if you let me know what you like, I can bring you some of your favorite dishes next time we meet.
Oh no, here
Apart
we go.
Apart from lotus flower crisps, what else do you like?
Everything. Paimon likes
anything
everything.
Sweet. And anything that's made from slimes.
Here's what I've drafted so far. Anything else you want to add?
No, this is excellent. I'm racking my brains, but I don't think you've missed a single thing.
Cause Ganyu's amazing.
Then we'll leave it as is.
I'll go make an official copy. Oh, perfect timing. We were just wrapping up our discussion here.
Good job, Ganyu.
Not at all. Every second counts for a complex proposal such as this. I will inform the Qixing of this development immediately. Please give me a moment to pass on the message. Yao Yao, thank you for bringing my herbs. I will make sure to take them.
Remember to make tea from them first, Ganyu. You mustn't just chew them raw.
I will.
But Ganyu likes eating them raw.
Okay, I should be getting back. If Yao Yao stays out for too long, Mom and Dad will be worried sick. Everyone, I'm sure that the music festival will go off without a hitch, so don't worry. And in case I don't see you before, I wish you all a very happy Lantern Rite.
Thank you, Yao Yao. Happy Lantern Rite to you, too.
We should go get dinner together sometime!
Paimon, please stop shouting. Okay. Stay put and wait for 2 hours. Okay. Easy. 2 hours. That was a bit more than 2 hours. There we go.
Greetings, Traveler, Paimon, and Mr. Dvorak. Call me Kuching. Ganyu has brought me up to speed on everything. I'll get straight to the point. The Qixing have approved Ganyu's proposal. Over the next few days, I will be working with Mr. Dvorak on behalf of the Qixing to facilitate the organization of this concert.
Yay! That's awesome!
Nice.
Please. The Qixing have a duty to deal with matters such as these. We have merely moved things forward to the next step. On a more personal note, I am an avid supporter of all things new and innovative. As such, it is my privilege to work with you on this exciting project.
Thank you so much, Kuching. I'd become quite discouraged after our recent failures and was expecting the same outcome once again, so I didn't dare to get my hopes up. Never in my wildest dreams could I have imagined this going so smoothly. It's like a dream come true. Right, time for me to call in the performers. To stage a concert at a high-profile event like this is a rare opportunity. We'll make sure it's a night to remember.
Yes! Our music man's finally getting fired up!
Yes, indeed. I know exactly what I'm doing from here. For a musician, music will always be the language they are most fluent in.
What about the fairy lady?
Oh, that. Well, that can wait for another time.
Okay.
Oh. Ganyu? What's wrong?
They told me all about Mr. Dvorak's situation, but I was so engrossed in drafting the proposal that I forgot all about it.
Oh, that's quite all right. I don't even know what the person I'm trying to find looks like, so it was always going to be a long shot. Don't worry about me, Ganyu. Your time and energy are needed elsewhere. I'm sure you already have plenty to deal with between this concert and everything else going on during the Lantern Rite.
We should talk to Jolly.
Thanks. It was just that I had a few initial thoughts when I heard your story. For instance, I wonder if this lady your ancestor met might have been an Adeptus. What do you think?
I think we've completely forgotten that the whole reason we ended up out there in the first place was to retrieve some bamboo shoots for Zhongli, and we should probably talk to him. Because he might have an idea.
To tell you the truth, Mr. Dvorak, I am somewhat related to the Adepti myself. I am part human and part Qilin. The Qilin is an illuminated beast. I know how important your quest to get in touch with your roots must be to you, because I've been there myself before, trying to find out where I belonged.
Did you say the Adepti? And you're illuminated beast, part Qilin? Are you telling me all the rumors of the Liyue Adepti are real? So it's not just artistic license?
Yes.
You bet they're real! Trying to track them down is tough, though. Like Jiyun Karst itself. There's nothing specifically stopping you from going there, but getting in and out of there is quite an ordeal.
Yes, it is.
Yes. Anyway, if you're looking to uncover a lost melody or shine light on a forgotten aspect of Liyue's cultural history, I'm probably not the best person to ask.
You should ask Zhongli.
But if it's a person you're looking for, then I just might be able to help.
Is it Zhongli?
I see. I think I understand the situation now. In that case, Ganyu, shall we divide the work between us?
Yes, that was also my thought.
Great. So Mr. Dvorak and I will concentrate on things here in the city to make sure the concert goes according to plan. In the meantime, Ganyu will reach out to our network and try to find the person he's looking for.
We should talk to Zhongli.
How's your workload at the moment? Will you be able to make time?
I can probably get through everything in 2 days, as long as I don't sleep.
Ganyu!
Wait, what do you mean, as long as I don't sleep? Even for someone with illuminated beast blood in their veins, working for such an extended period without a break will take its toll on your health.
Thank you.
Somehow that does not sound persuasive coming from Kuching.
Be it but 3 moons from the start, he who returns is not he that departs. Even I know the importance of maintaining a healthy work-life balance.
In that case, 3 days.
All right, I can work with that.
If you have the time, would you join me for this search?
Yes, I'll
You're
talk
well
to
known to many of the Adepti and respected among the people. I'll feel much more at ease with your company.
Aww. Love you too, Ganyu.
Okay, then let's meet back here in 3 days.
What's this space, Mr. Dvorak? We'll get to the bottom of this.
You're all so helpful and kind. I just...
Just think. Imagine if we found the Adeptus Lady or one of her descendants and got them to come to the performance. Wouldn't that be amazing? It'd be such a happy reunion. And that's exactly what this festival's all about.
Yep.
You're right. Okay. I'm gonna pull out all the stops to make this lantern rite a true extravaganza.
We should probably get going. Mr. Dvorak, could you come with me to confirm the site?
Ooh, we're coming to you!
I thought we were going with Ganyu.
I was wondering, what are your thoughts on music? What does it mean to you?
Music sounds nice?
Wow, Paimon.
Truth be told, the question of what music means to people is one that I've been pondering for quite some time. Let's
oh my
revisit
God,
this
I can land on
after the concert.
Music is incredible. Hello, Lexi, babe.
Lady,
too true.
Bywin, what is it?
Hope you're ready to be comfy with us.
Per Lady
I'm
Ning
glad
Wong's
you like
orders,
the emotes.
I've been gathering intelligence outside of the city with the goal of uncovering and dispatching any trouble ahead of the festival. I am told that a strange melody was heard somewhere along the coast. I was wary of investigating further on my own, so I was just on my way to report this incident to Lady Ning Wong.
I agree. Shiny Umbreon is the best evolution. Shiny Umbreon is my favorite Pokemon, so I might be a little biased.
But I'm worried that if we don't act right away, we may miss the window of opportunity to take appropriate action.
I understand. In that case, I...
Yeah, Kuching, you're busy enough as it is. There's a ton of different things in the city that needs your attention. Leave it to us! Don't worry, whatever it is, we'll definitely be able to handle it. Well, she will handle it.
Thank you.
With the traveler on the case, it's as good as dealt with.
Get
Thank
comfy
you.
With us, Lexi.
This will be a great help.
We're doing Lantern Rite story today.
I will inform
Lady
Ning Wong about the situation. Once it's resolved, please come and find me again at Yujing Terrace and let me know.
Will do! And say hi to Ning Wong for us!
You have my thanks, too. Stay safe and come back as soon as you're finished.
Good luck.
Calls it the waifu and himbo game. Hold on, let me think for a minute. I don't think any of the male characters in here are himbos. Well, as I open the character selection, Child isn't actually a himbo, but he sure likes to act like one. Same goes for Toma. He's not, but he sure likes to act like one. Yeah, nope. I don't think there's any characters that fit that definition here. Waifus, though? You know, pretty women? Yes. All of the characters are very well designed. A lot of work clearly goes into them. And I'm always impressed by that. And they all have a lot of personality. Like, it's not just the same character over and over again. They all have personality and story, and even the NPCs do, actually. If you actually pay attention and go through and talk to NPCs and, like, really experience the game, something that always impressed me so much about this game was that even the NPCs have story. And that's just really cool. I love that. I don't know much about the NPCs' stories in, like, Sumeru and stuff, because I haven't actually done much there. But I can tell you all about the NPC stories in, like, Mondstadt and Liyue. Like, personality, because it's so much more immersive? Yes. Like, that's the thing. If this was just, like, pretty characters go brr, I probably wouldn't like this game. I like story. I like story. I like character development. I like dynamic characters. Not just round characters. I like dynamic characters.
Byron said the strange tomb is coming from around here, right? But Byron doesn't hear anything. There doesn't seem to be a soul in...
I was just wondering who in their right mind would come out to a place like this. So, it's you two.
Hi, Yelan.
Yelan? How'd you sneak up on us like that? You nearly gave Paimon a heart attack!
Paimon, everybody gives you a heart attack.
You look pretty alive to me. Can't have spooked you that bad.
You...
Pretty characters do go brr, though. Pretty characters do go brr. It is nice to look at a pretty character. I can admire a nice design. Yelan, you know anything about this music?
Ah, you're here for that too? Saves me a bit of explaining.
Oh, you probably have more information than I do. Tell me.
Come with me. I've already reconned the perimeter, so we should be safe.
I mean, not that that's necessary. I'll be fine, but like, sure. Okay, thanks. Appreciate you, Yelan.
The doors and the windows are all fine. So there definitely wasn't a break-in.
Yelan does have a nice voice. I agree.
The stuff by the door is in pretty good condition, though. It can't have been too long ago that someone was last living here.
My cat is here, by the way, so, like, if I start doing strange things, it's because there's a cat tail in front of my camera. Enjoy.
This place is completely empty. There's nothing valuable left here at all. How strange. It looks like it's been looted, except for the fact that there's no sign of a struggle.
There wouldn't need to be a struggle for people to just open a box.
Sneaked in while the owner was gone, but then how do you explain why the door and windows are intact?
Because they only took
what
was in the boxes.
Seems you've done a pretty thorough inspection. So, any theories on what might have happened here?
Things might have been left unlocked?
You didn't hide some of the evidence from us on purpose, did you?
Actually, that sounds like something you might do.
Why would it make this more difficult for you? We're on the same side here.
Because you like
okay,
to test
well,
people?
Paimon gives up then. Paimon's got nothing.
What about you? Give up as well?
Sure. Difficult to theorize with so little evidence. Well, yeah.
Yep. It's not obvious at first sight, that's for sure.
Tell me what you
to
know.
To be honest, I was only able to put it all together because of some background knowledge about this area.
There you go. See?
A long time ago, there used to be a group of bandits in the Liyue countryside who would sound a horn every time they were about to raid a village.
Okay.
But it wasn't a rallying cry to rouse their fellow men. It was a disconcerting tune, meant to intimidate the weak and warn them of their impending doom.
I see.
To escape with their lives, the villagers would abandon their homes and flee overnight, taking only their most valuable belongings with them. Everything else was left behind.
Is that what you're saying
happened? The bandits were eventually brought to justice. but the fear and trauma remained in the villagers' hearts. Whenever they heard that melody, they would feel like their lives were in danger once again, and flee immediately. The culprit of this crime exploited that very fear to get access to this house without having to force their way in.
So somebody
that's quite
old
the
enough to have that trauma.
The victims obviously will have gotten quite a fright, but at least they won't be in any great danger. The important thing now is to find this copycat criminal.
Kitties always interrupt your streams too, but we love them. Don't have to worry about cam things, just cat heavy breathing in mic. Oh, I'm pretty sure that my marshmallows would love it if Sarah were to come up here and shove her face in the mic and just do heavy cat breathing noises. I'm pretty sure they would love that.
On any other day, that'd probably be a good idea. Unfortunately, it's not gonna work today. Take a look around and you'll see what I mean. This criminal is clearly well-versed both in using music to commit crimes and in making a clean getaway. Not only did they stay off the muddy road to avoid leaving footprints, it looks like they were also careful not to bring any gadgets with so much as a trace of elemental energy. Evidently, they were intent on keeping even the most experienced investigators off their trail. Unfortunately for them, I'm one of the best trackers in the business.
Yep.
They're not about to get away with their little scheme on my watch.
We don't need mud and elemental energy to track someone.
So basically, if we want to find the culprit, we just need to follow Yaelon!
Yup. Look for disturbed things. Including grass.
Mm-hmm. As long as you can keep up.
Since
the culprit's trying to be cautious and low risk, I'll bet they left through an area with some vegetation for cover, but not so much that it would slow them down.
Alright, we follow Yaelon. Okay, but actually
here,
she might be
this.
Running a little faster than me.
These tracks are superficial, but they definitely didn't occur naturally. Something heavy was being dragged this way, meaning we're headed in the right direction.
Grass, what's grass? It's this amazing thing that can actually cause cuts to your fingers, like paper cuts.
Their pace is increased.
And you can whistle with it.
Normally, people carrying a heavy load slow down as their journey goes on and they start to tire.
And sometimes it's soft.
Whatever's motivating them to speed up must be psychological. For instance, reaching the home stretch.
And it makes a very particular smell when cut. And it stains white things, like shoes and clothing. So don't wear white clothing around it. It'll turn them green. And also, it likes to get up in your nose. And it's itchy.
Here they are! Look! A treasure hoarder tent! Ugh, not the treasure hoarders again! And so close to Lantern Rite, too! Tis not the season for their antics!
Come on, let's round them up.
We doing a fight? We doing a fight. I'm good at fighting. Jump, Zhongli. You can do it. Wait, we're not fighting?
Who are you? Where did you come from?
I came to beat you up without asking questions first. That's how we do things in this game, right?
The evidence is conclusive. Okay, confess and we'll go easy on you. My patience is running low, so why don't you do us both a favor,
You kidding me? You think I'm scared of you?
Oh, you should be.
Perhaps not, but you should be.
Okay, we're doing this again. Oh, what? Okay. I was not expecting to be forced to use Yaelon.
Curses. Seems like you're not all talk after all. There's no going back now. Better up my game.
Excuse me, you're cheating. Why aren't you taking damage? Where'd you go?
Mercy! Have mercy!
No.
Oh. It's a little late for that. I've come this far, I might as well finish the job.
This is why I
surrender!
Like
I surrender, please!
I'll do whatever you say. Please have mercy.
Tell us everything. You have one chance, and I'm warning you. Don't make me ask twice.
I won't, I swear. You know, so Lantern Rite's nearly here, and like a lot of people, I wanted to buy a few nice things.
So you stole some stuff.
I know I'm with the treasure hoarders and everything, but I don't really have any kind of experience with robbing people and whatnot. So I don't have the guts to break into somebody's house.
Wow, you're really going to complain to us about that?
Yep.
No, not at all. I'm just telling it how it is.
Why are you a treasure hoarder?
Okay, continue.
I racked my brains trying to think of what I could do, and eventually I remembered something from back when I was a kid. The bandits would blow their horn, and my grandma would grab us kids and run. I remember the tune, so I figured I'd try it for myself. I mean, just to see what would happen. At first, anyway, I seriously didn't expect that family to pack up and leave. But they did, and they just left all their stuff right there for the taking. It was too easy. I couldn't resist. It was completely wrong of me. I know that now. I'll return everything that I took. It's all still in perfect condition, and it'll be like it was never gone. Please, give me a chance, huh? Let me make it right.
No, you already did it.
Give you a chance, huh? Sounds to me like you'd rather strike some kind of a deal than spend Lantern Rite behind bars.
Yes. Yes.
You know how to bargain, I'll give you that. It's just a pity that you didn't confess at the first opportunity. You'll have to take a walk with me. Once we've returned the goods, we'll find the owner of the house, and you can apologize to them in person. After that, I'll escort you to the Ministry of Civil Affairs.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, as a former victim of this kind of crime yourself, I doubt anyone understands the fear you inflicted quite as well as you do.
Which makes
Does
it extra
bad. Does your greed matter more to you than your fear? More to the point, if you can play a tune from memory, don't you think you should be capable of making an honest living?
You mean...
not stealing from people? Not being a treasure hoarder?
That's enough hints for you. You'll have plenty of time to reflect on all of this yourself. There's not much left to wrap up, so I'll take it from here. Guess this is where I'll say goodbye.
Okay.
What is it? Is there something else?
I'm still not sure how you first got your hands on this information. So play it safe when you get back. Don't mention to anyone that you ran into me out here.
Okay.
You helped a lot with the investigation and arrest anyway, so it's perfectly fair for you to get all the credit. Just take it. It works better for me, too.
Yelan whispers.
See you when I see you. And happy Lantern Rite.
Yelan's such a pro at this. With her taking it from here, it's as good as resolved. Whoosh! Random event, a strange melody, complete! Although, it's kind of a shame that we never got that treasure hoarder guy to play the melody again.
I'm actually kind of curious myself, but like, what if other people heard it and then they got scared too?
Right? How could anyone not be? When we were chatting with Mr. Dvorak, music seemed like such a positive thing. And most music is, right? It can help us relax, feel all warm and fuzzy, recall happy memories, or even just think happy thoughts. Paimon never imagined that music could be used to commit crimes.
I'm pretty sure anything can be used to commit crimes. It just depends on the person.
Oh, really? Huh. Makes sense. Paimon's musical understanding improves again! Well, anyway, now that everything's resolved, let's get back to Liyue Harbor. Paimon's still waiting for us with our random event rewards.
I really didn't like that rain in the country. Where are we going? Oh, that's quite a trek. We'll teleport. Hey, cat, want to see this trick?
Rain stopped. I don't concern myself with the weather.
Of course you don't, cat. So there's this trick. If you ever need to get over here, you can just teleport up to this mountain up here and just jump right down. a lot faster. I've shown it to you before, but never hurts to show it again. There might be people who didn't know about it.
Worthless!
And I'm always happy to spread useful information. Oops.
Violet,
we might have killed
back.
Them.
Everything's all sorted!
That's great news!
You okay?
Oh, please wait here a moment, if you would be so kind. Lady Ningguang instructed me to advise her upon your return.
Oh, okay. She seems to be okay after we plummeted down on top of her. That's good.
Yeah, my greetings to both of you. Long time no see.
Hello, my queen.
No need to be so formal with us, Ningguang. We've known each other for a long time now. You must be super busy with all the preparations for Lantern Rite. Don't mind us.
On the contrary, I think it is those that I have known longest to whom I should extend the greatest courtesies. Alas, on a different day, I would invite both of you inside for some tea and a brief respite from your travels.
We could do that.
But
anyway.
You're quite right. Trivial matters aside, there's no escaping the fact that we have a grand concert to organize. Once the performance itself is over, we'll then need to invite the representatives of the Iridescence Tour for a discussion on future collaboration opportunities. The financing arrangements alone could well entail many rounds of discussion.
She is so pretty.
Simply
She's
put,
our queen.
There will always be work to do.
Ningguang's my favorite.
Whoa, you're already thinking that far ahead?
Well, we can discuss more current affairs if you'd prefer.
Sure.
I trust you saw this year's Ming Xiao lantern at the docks when you arrived at the city?
No, nobody showed it to me yet.
It looked like a goose. Which Adeptus is it modeled on this time?
Seagazer. I believe you're familiar with the name. Legend holds that he was free-spirited and easygoing. People described him as a cheerful soul and a loyal friend.
Aw. See, do I remember Seagazer? Let's do the it's been too long. Let's get the story.
On this marvelous lantern rite, we pray that the fallen heroes may be guided home. If the sound of music can flow like the rivers and streams into every corner of the land, perhaps the souls of those who have gone before us will hear the song of a new era. I wonder whether the melodies will be to their liking.
Oh, they're gonna love them. Paimon's sure of it. At least, if the guy you mentioned is anything to go by, the Adepti and heroes of the past sound like a positive and free-spirited, cheerful bunch.
Cheerful.
They're sure to be open to new music.
Well, let's hope so. I heard that you'll be going on a search with Ganyu to find the descendants of a fairy lady from a Fontaine legend.
Yes.
I'm sure this quest to uncover the truth behind an ancient story will turn into a most charming tale. Do share it with me, won't you? I couldn't bear to miss out.
Oh, Ningguang. I will always share stories with you. Anything you want. Oh! Cutscene? Oh! Okay, well, I guess this is the event menu? Let's see. Okay. So we've got some side quests, looks like. This one's first, so we'll start with it. Let me show you something, though. This is Ningguang's other outfit. Whoop, wrong button. She's our favorite character, so of course, we have her other outfit, too. It's very pretty. The dark blue. Zoom in so you can see the other details. She's got a different hairpin. Different hairpin in the front here too. And like all the different jewelry on her hands. It's pretty nice. I like it a lot. I like the color. Continuing. Ningguang was actually the first character in this game that I wanted. She has been my favorite since before I played. I started playing for Ningguang. Let's get a look at this lantern. and look at this year's Ming Zhao lantern. Look at that. So this is the big lantern that gets set off at the end of Lantern Rite. There's all these little lanterns that are set off all the time. And then there's this big one that's like an entire big scene, and it's really cool. One of the Lantern Rite festivals, the one I remember the most, was with this one. I forget his name, but we can actually go to his little shrine up in the mountains. It's been too long. But his lantern was beautiful. It was a big deer, and what it did was it had a long glowing tail, kind of like a comet, and it just pranced across the sky, and it was so pretty. Happy Lantern Rite? Yes. Having fun? Sure. Go on a special adventure? Why not? Just trying to read a little bit so I know what's going on. Everyone and their cats and dogs passing by, I probably heard your voice. Sure, you look familiar. What are we doing? Got a novel, okay. Adventure stuff. You want to get people into the Adventurers Guild? Okay. Consulted some people. There's mechanisms laid out in the challenge. All right. So we're supposed to blow stuff up. Rock firework flying by, Mon, sure. Exploding barrels. Okay. Racing challenge. And there's rewards. All right. Okay. Oops. So everything's unlocked because we're already almost at the end of the thing. Let's go ahead and move on to the next quest though. If we have a lot of time extra, we'll come back and do these little mini games. But right now, we're looking for story. Oh, is this the pictures again? A performance, okay. Let's see. Hello? A paper play. Oh, that's neat! Bravebeard. Long. So we have to pick the parts. We're not doing the parts featuring monsters. Okay. A lonely girl named Yibing and an honest gentleman named Nanfeng. Story about a guy called Bravebeard. Paimon, just stop talking. Okay, I understand this is a paper play. I know that. The play is made of paper, TLDR. Okay, we're gonna get the rundown on Bravebeard. said that the sky's the limit, but the woes of the world are also limitless. There was once a man named Huang Huang, suffering from human injustice, who resorted to dwelling amongst the mountains and rivers. By chance, he became a disciple of an adeptus, changed his appearance, and grew a black beard. Thus, he is known as the Brave Beard. At the behest of the adeptus, he struck down monsters and scared off demons with his sword. The Brave Beard trained for many years and finally acquired the philosophy of the adeptus. Right before he returned to the adeptal abode, he was summoned to recall the past. It turned out that he still had an attachment to the common folk society, where he had a sister at home. The poor sister, Yi Bing, was now alone and helpless. She thought that her brother had lived a miserable life, and never imagined that he would return home. As to what happened next, I'll show you right away. Alright, time for the play? Clap? Oh, okay. More backstory? What? You know nothing about it, so you should come up here and help me do the scene. Excuse me? No. Okay. I guess we're gonna help direct the scene that we know nothing about. Alright, so I'm guessing that's gonna be another event thing. Oh, that's how we continue the story. Okay. Let's go ahead and just continue the story then. If we don't need to do all these side quests. Where? Oh, in 2 days. Oh, hold on then. Where's the... There we go. Okay. You need training test. I don't think these are going to be important. So we'll just continue the story. 8 to 10 o'clock, 2 days later.
World.
1, 2... If only we could make it go faster. At least we can progress the day at all. At least we don't have to, like, wait forever. Oh, nay. Okay, so now we need to go to 8 o'clock. We were just a few minutes off. Just a few. Let me do it. I won't let. Okay, well.
Turning the unknown into the known.
It's okay.
I think it's about time for us to meet up with Ganyu. Let's head to Eugene Terrace.
So we go up here, and we can jump down from the top of the cliff again. And we use Zhao so that we don't take any damage. Zhao looks good with the lightning glider. It matches him. Dive, dive, dive! Oh no. Ganyu, you didn't sleep, did you? You said you would sleep.
Greetings, traveler and Paimon. What time is it?
Are you okay, Ganyu?
8 a.m.
You were nodding off there. Didn't you sleep well last night?
I'm fine. Don't worry about me. Let's discuss the matter at hand. Since last time, I've been thinking a lot about the story Paimon told me.
Oh yeah?
In essence, someone rescued a drowning man and performed some music.
Yes.
If that were all there was to it, it could have been many people. Human or adeptus.
But the music
but
was particularly lovely.
But the tune was allegedly so wonderful that the drowning man forgot about everything else. Even his own impending death, and only came to his senses after being brought to shore. Perhaps there was an adeptal power at work in that music that he, as a mortal, could not perceive. Or perhaps he sensed a power surrounding him but lacked the words to describe it, not knowing where it came from. Either way, if this part of the story is true, then the rescuer has to have been an Adeptus.
You really think so? But this story is all the way from Fontaine. Isn't this a bit of a long shot? Also, Paimon's really curious about how people from Fontaine think this fairy lady looked.
I kind of wonder if it wasn't an wait. I know who it is. I won't spoil it for you. I know who it is. It's Liyue. Think about glaze lilies. Maybe they gave her horns, maybe they imagined her having wings.
Ooh, like a crystal fly's wings? That would be pretty cool. But Paimon definitely can't imagine any of the Adepti looking like that. Actually, Ganyu, if you had to save a drowning person, how would you go about it?
Just get them out of the water?
Me? Well, I'd get them to the shore, and then I'd probably hide behind a tree and watch them for a while. Once I was sure that they were going to be okay, I'd slip away without a sound.
Ganyu's cute. You're so shy. You could make sure they're okay by actually talking to them, Ganyu.
Got it.
It's okay.
So basically, Ganyu's the type of person who doesn't like taking credit for her good deeds.
No, it's not like that. I'm just not very good at explaining things. And I also find it really awkward accepting other people's gratitude.
I understand.
Well, what if this Adeptus in the story had a similar attitude? That would explain why she just left without saying a word. She was probably thinking something like,
one was merely passing by and saw fit to address this egregious disruption to one's graceful zithering at once. You may keep your thanks to yourself.
You channeling Cloud Retainer there, Paimon? Channeling Mama Bird?
That was actually a very good impression of Cloud Retainer, Paimon. As far as I'm aware, Cloud Retainer isn't the most musically gifted. Still, we can't completely rule her out just yet. If we set off now, we could head to Mount Outsung and ask her about it. You'll be able to confirm either way if it's her, and I can... I've been in Lea Harbor for so long now that I'm just not as familiar with the Adepti anymore. If there's anything we want to know about them, she's the best person to ask.
Sounds great! And we're pretty close with Cloud Retainer by now, so we probably don't even need to bring her food this time, right?
I've prepared a gift for her to mark the festival, just in case. However? Cloud Retainer spends most of her days studying mechanisms in her abode. She's on her own so much of the time that the moment she has someone to chat with, she just...
She talks a lot.
Never mind. I promised I'd help Mr. Dvorak, and now that I've made the contract, I can't be having second thoughts.
It's okay, I like talking to Mama Bird.
Traveler? Paimon? Let's set off for Cloud Retainer's abode.
Okay, Ganyu.
Seems like this is a tough decision for Ganyu, but she's made up her mind now. Paimon gets why she'd be so anxious. Okay, how about this? If Cloud Retainer tries to start telling stories about her again this year, we should pipe up and change the topic.
But I like hearing Cloud Retainer's
story.
Did
she leave already? Hey, Ganyu, wait up!
But what if I like Cloud Retainer's story? Oh. Well, it's getting a little late. I've got to work on dinner and stuff. So I know we haven't been going very long, and we've still got more of the festival to do. But we're going to pause here, and we can continue tomorrow. Probably start around the same time, sometime in the afternoon. Afternoon EST time. For everyone else, because I know not everybody has the same time zone.
All is accounted for. Let's move out.
Get our party back to normal.
Whatever would you do without me?
That way I can come right in and do my stuff. And let's go ahead We'll find our raid target. Wait for it. Oh, while Twitch is taking its time loading, let me get it in the raid message for you all. And get the emote on the end for everyone that has it. There you go. So go ahead and grab that, copy paste it. We're gonna find our raid target. Let's see. Oh, I know who our raid target is. Raid target acquired. Raid target acquired. We're gonna raid Sarg. Sarg is playing Pokemon, which is what we're playing when we're not playing Genshin Impact right now. So let's go ahead and raid Sarg so you can all get your Pokemon fix. I think he's getting towards the end of the game, possibly. I know he's almost done with his Pokedex, so just in case you don't want spoilers, just in case. But let's go ahead and get ready here. Start the raid timer. Oof. There we go. Alright. Grab your raid message, everyone. I will see you tomorrow. Thanks for coming. And have a great night. Bye-bye, everyone. Doo-doo.